mode, oh, WWE 2K23 showcase mode, where at SummerSlam, once again, it's Batista, and it's Dead Man. It's stuff.
I think with Batista, you see this mountain of an individual, over 6 feet, 300 pounds plus, tattoos, shaved head. There's a whole lot more than meets the eye.
I've never admitted this to anyone, but for 6 years I've been watching you.
I had the perspective of he always had something to prove, like through all of his success, which is his Hall of Fame career, it always felt like he was giving off the energy that he always had something to prove.
I lash out, and when I lash out, people get hurt.
I've had a lot of matches with Batista, and I think all of them mean something, because anytime you get two performers that are at a level of success, both Batista and John Cena were loved by the audience. Very rarely was the perception of good guy versus good guy equals good event. It's always usually a disappointment. And then I kind of came in and shook everything up, where it was almost like the John Cena character will be good until we put him with another good guy, and then the audience can turn on him.
We're gonna find out who's better!
The answer's gonna be me.
But it made for a lot of tough nights with me, because even the nights that I did well, it was like I was playing on the road every night. I never had a home game.
There's an explosion brewing at the biggest blockbuster of the summer!
I was more than ready to test myself against Batista's power. But with someone like him, one wrong move is too many. One second I'm flying in the air, and the next I'm hearing his music playing, and he's announced the winner. I wanted that win, really bad. I wanted to put my stamp on the whole who's better discussion between me and Batista. But now I knew the stakes, and any time we'd compete, I wouldn't mess up that same way again.
Okay, a crowd tour. Which must be that way. Oh. Yep. And then a front heavy. Release back suplex. Yep, okay. Standing behind. And then standing in front, do that. Let's see if I remember it all. A dart, I've just forgotten. Left today. Full leg lock, and then do orange damage to the legs. Woo! So I'm gonna do damage to his legs, which is gonna be really hard. But I'm just gonna have to keep doing shit like this, and eventually I'll get orange. That one into the legs. That was to the arm. And he reversed that. But I reversed that one. And he reversed that one. And I reversed that one. And he's stunned. So I'll just keep going after the legs. Hey, yellow. Come on, orange. There we go, that's orange. Front heavy grapple. So, three combos and then a spine buster. And a reversal straight away is a great sign. That's one. And another reversal. Stuttery there. That's two. And another reversal. And that's three. And that's a spine. Batista bomb. Okay, bear. And then reverse. Missed that. Bear hug is just seated on the top turnbuckle. Okay. And he's going for an AA, which is reversed. And then saving to the ropes. So Batista ball and then the win. Let's go for it. It's going to kick in. Or is it?
Here is your winner, the Animal Batista.
And that's all that I've watched. So, next up we've got Randy Orton versus John Cena. I believe that there must be more than 14. We'll play through a bit. So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13. This is 14. Now there's at least 15, 16 there. So. Yeah, there was more than that. I thought there was 14. I read somewhere that was 14. There's obviously more. So next one we're going to Hell in a Cell 2009 against Randy Orton. So, yeah. Like, share, subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, follow the Facebook, Twitter, and Twitch. Links those are in the description. Let me know if you love the episode in the comment section down below. And on that, thanks for watching. Goodbye. Good night.